As an editor, you have the power to move around your media on the timeline any way you'd like. And in this lesson, Nick is going to teach you a few tricks to help out. I'm your host, Dylan, and welcome back to MotionVFX Academy.
As easy and fluent as it is to edit clips into your Final Cut Pro timeline with append, insert, and connect, so is rearranging and trimming them. Final Cut allows you several ways of doing this. By default, clips move magnetically, meaning that when you move or trim one clip in your timeline, the rest of it will compensate to make sure no gaps or spaces are left in the timeline. Let's learn how we can move, delete, trim clips, as well as use another tool in order to drag clips free from this magnetism. I'm here in my Paradise project, which we left off with in the last movie. First off, I would like to move the last clip in the timeline earlier, just before the fourth last clip. I'll select that clip, which is going to be identified by the yellow outline. And once I start to drag this to the left in between the edit point of the next two clips, we can see there that the last clip moves out of its way in order to make room for this clip magnetically responding. And if I continue to drag between the edit points here in my timeline, you'll see that they'll compensate. I'll now release my mouse and this clip has been replaced. When you select a clip that has a connected clip on top of it, it is going to come along for the ride when you move it. In fact, I'll drag this clip all the way to the beginning of the timeline, seeing all of my clips move in order to make room for it. I'll now select the audio and click and drag it so it's now connected to the first clip in my timeline. If you decide to delete a clip that has connected clips on it, you'll want to note that the connected clips will also be deleted. I've selected the first clip that I've just moved in the timeline, and now I press delete, both the audio and the title disappear. If I press Command Z to undo that, the great thing about connected clips is if they expand beyond the first clip is that you can change their connection point. One way to do so, hold down the Command and Option key and click on the upper portion of the audio line. And if I move my playhead out of the way, you'll see that that connection point has changed. The same thing would be true of this title is if we extended its length and then held Command and Option down at the actual frame to which we would like to change that connection point. If I now selected that first clip in the timeline and press delete, both the clips connected to the second clip stick with it. I'm going to press Command Z to undo those changes. As easy as it is to move and delete clips in the timeline, so is extending or removing frames from a clip. I'm going to select this second clip in my timeline and press the / key to play it back. The clip is a little bit too short, and I'd like to extend it by its out point for 2 additional seconds. In order to do this, I will move my default selection tool over the out point and click to select it. I can now click and drag, where we can see all of the adjacent clips make room for this out point extension. On top of the ability to be able to drag to where you would like to trim your clip, I will press undo, and we can also do this numerically. With that out point still selected on the second clip, I'll press Shift+2. If you look underneath the viewer, you'll see that I currently see that I'm about to move the out point of the second clip by 2 seconds. Once I press return, that clip is now extended. Now, it should be noted that you cannot extend a clip beyond the amount of handles that you have. If I continue to drag this clip by its out point, eventually, we're going to see a red indicator letting me know that there are no handles beyond this point for the clip, meaning that I cannot extend it any further. I'll press Command Z to undo that. Now, if you come from another NLE, using the magnetic timeline might take some getting used to. And for that, there's also the position tool. We select this from the toolbar. So click on this arrow next to my selection tool and select position. When you select a clip and then begin to drag with the position tool, the area from which you move it will be replaced with a gap clip. It should also be noted that when you drag it over an existing shot in the primary storyline, it will overwrite that clip, meaning that it's destructive. Is that you can drag it beyond your timeline and save clip assemblies for later if you like that workflow. Let me press Command Z to undo that position change, followed by Shift Z so that we can see all of those clips. I'm going to shift back to my default selection tool by pressing A and draw your attention towards these three clips that are connected to a gap clip in my primary storyline. When you have connected clips and start to try to rearrange them, you don't get the same magnetism as you do in the primary storyline. For such as B-roll clips, what you should do is select all of those clips that are connected, head to the clip menu, where you can choose Create Storyline. All of a sudden, the connection points for all of those clips have disappeared, and there is now a gray bar on top of them. This is a new storyline, which will allow us to now have that magnetism for what was once these connected clips. Now let's review all this. Clips can easily be moved around and trimmed in the primary storyline, while all your clips stay together. I'll take this third clip here in the timeline and just move it later, noting that the gap clip and the connected secondary storyline move earlier in the timeline. We can also easily trim clips by selecting the in and out point of them, extending them, or dragging them in to shorten them. I'll press Command Z to undo. On top of the default selection tool, you also have the position tool available, which allows you to move clips free from magnetism, but will leave gaps as well as is destructive when you drag it over top of another clip. And lastly, when required, we can create additional storylines with connected clips to move them magnetically.